November 1st. And I'm back at it again on an evening hunt. It's a warm day. It's like 50 something degrees. And it's supposed to be a warm week. So I'm thinking that today is gonna be the last day of good daylight movement, because it's gonna be warm during midday. So I think the rest of the week the deer are gonna be moving more at night. So I'm gonna sit tight tonight and hopefully I can get some action tonight for you guys. So stay tuned, should be good. Set up again, and I bumped like three does on the way in here, and crunchy conditions, so if any deer are gonna come this way, I hope I can hear them. It's been quiet the last couple times I've been out, so you can't really hear them until they're right up on you. But today the leaves have been super dry and crunchy walking in.
shot a doe. And she ran that way. She was under my stand. I left my jacket down there. And she kept running around sniffing to see what it was. Guys, I just shot a doe. I waited to see if there was anything behind it, and I didn't hear anything, so it's still early. It's only like maybe not even 3 o'clock yet. There's still a deer out there feeding on acorns. But I got 2 tags, and so I just shot a doe. I'm sure she's dead. I think I put a good hit on it, so I'm just gonna wait to see if a big boy shows up, and then I'll go down and track my deer. But there's a doe out that way. Move the camera back. She came behind me, so like my camera couldn't wrap around the other way. So I didn't get the shot on video, but I got her coming out. She came out in front of me that way. But there's the other deer. Deer are moving tonight. That one's coming this way too, I think. Hopefully it brings a buck with it. Let's go. I was gonna sit until it got dark, but I'm hunting with my cousin, and he's a rookie. He also shot a doe, so he already came down to get me. So I got down. Here's what saved me. I just threw that there in my backpack there, but my jacket I left at the base of the tree here. And I didn't think that the deer was gonna come downwind of me, but they did. And the whole time the doe was focused on what that was. And so she stuck around trying to investigate to see what that was. Gave me a 10-yard shot. Let's go take a look at the point of impact. Blood right away. Saw it coming out right at the shot. She ran off that way. Yeah, just a bunch of blood. There's my arrow. Should be an easy track job. The muzzy did its thing again. There's my muzzy. And again, that is what you want to see. That is what you want to see. Arrow full of blood. This is second deer with this broadhead. So let's track more blood that way. Should be an easy track job. Blood there. Blood. 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 Blood over here. Blood. I think I see a white belly over there. See a white belly. Oh, there's blood here. There she is. Right through here. There she is. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, dear. Thank you so much. Good sized doe. This is the exit. Oh, perfect shot. Right into and through the boiler room. My first doe of the season. Today is November 1st, 2020. I think last year I shot a little button buck on November 1st also. But the deer were moving today. And if my cousin didn't get down, I would have stayed a little bit longer to see if a buck would show up, but my cousin came down because he also shot a doe, so. But thank God, and gotta thank the wife, thank the kids, the family. They are the ones that suffer and they have to stay home. And when we're out here in the woods, then we're taking time away from them. And I know sometimes it can be tough that they spend the mornings or all day or the weekends and the evenings by themselves. But I wanna thank them and thank God. This is why we do it. Here's the entrance wound. Fixed blade, muzzy, 100 grain. And the arrow. She was like right under the stand, so perfect angle. Came in there and right out the other side, right under the armpit. So, there we go, entrance wound. Now the work starts.